Rae Holliday is the co-creator of StuffFlyPeopleLike.com. Mm-hmm. He is also the creator of the Holiday Agency. He is also, I don't want to sound like I do a million things, even though I sound like I do a million things. And I know that people have this warped perception, like when you do too many, it's like everybody in New York is like an actor, a waiter, a publicist, a blogger, and they're just like, but you can't really be that. So I would think a blogger, a media personality, and a manager. That's who Rae Holliday is. Shout out to Stuff Fly People Like was born 6.5 years ago. It's a blog that merges fashion, music, and entertainment. And out of that blog has come so many amazing opportunities. During the course of the blog, people will always ask me, because we worked with a lot of fashion brands, a lot of designers when we would do our spotlights, and they will always say, well, can you rep me or do you do representation? I'm like, no, I don't do that. It was something that I always wanted to do, but my BA, a lot of people don't know, my BA is in criminal justice and my minor is in English. And so journalism is just something that I've always been into. So repping people doesn't really have anything to do with criminal justice. But I knew, based on all my experiences with other publicists and just a lot of learning and working with a lot of them, that it was something that I could do. So about 1.5 years ago, I hit up 6 of those very same clients who would always hit me up and ask me if I could help them out. And I said, okay. I delivered 6 points of the Holiday Agency that I wanted to be realistic. I knew one of the biggest problems, I can't really say anywhere else, but one of the biggest problems with publicists in New York City is that there were a lot of, I don't want to call them fake publicists, but a lot of them were using that publicist hat to kind of rip people off and go about their business. And it's a cycle. They'd say, hey, I used to work with J-Lo. This is my resume. This is what I did for her. They wouldn't say that they only worked for J-Lo for 3 months, but to you, I work for J-Lo. And then they take your money and take you on this whole trip for 3 months. For the whole 3 months, you don't really see any results. And when it's time for you to let them go, you're on their resume and they're off to the next one. And so this person is like stuck with out of $4,000 and not know where to turn. So I knew there was a market for like really genuine representation. And I said, well, first things first is I'm going to build a list of things that I know I could do, because I didn't want any deliverable that I really couldn't deliver. And I felt real confident, and I sent it to 6 of them. I said, this is the Holiday Agency. These are my points. These are the prices. And within 24 hours, they all said yes. I didn't consider myself an influencer a few years ago. Now I do. I think being an influencer and being a tastemaker in New York City has a different meaning to me now, because when I was on the outside, I would see people who they were considered influencers and tastemakers. I would just say, why? And I would just, but then I realized that it's a difference between people calling you an influencer and you calling yourself an influencer. So for a long time, I'm like, I'm not calling myself an influencer. So somebody could be like, that's self-made. No, you man-made. We the people didn't elect you as an influencer. So I'm just like, okay, I guess I'm just going to have to wait till somebody calls me an influencer. I could be like, yes, my time has come. I think that what I always tell people is that influencers influence influencers. So there can be, let's say, a Kim Kardashian, and there can be a Bevy Smith. Kim Kardashian has 7.5 million followers, and Bevy Smith have a smooth 150K. But when you look at Kim K's following, people are literally just following her because she's Kim K. Oh, Keeping Up with Kardashians, that's a girl? Click. That's the one who's with Kanye? Click. Oh, she got a store somewhere? Click. She's on TV? Click. When it comes to Bevy, you have to know her influence to even want to follow her. And then she's followed by the influencers. So like Diddy follows her, but does Diddy follow Kim Kardashian? Brands follow Bevy. Target follows Bevy, but does Target follow Kim Kardashian? So as an influencer, she has influencers who follow her, so she'll affect way more people than Kim Kardashian ever will. And people don't understand that, because I used to say, I don't have enough numbers to be an influencer. And I sat in a meeting once and they said, well, who follows you? So I said, okay. At that time, Gaga was following me. Britney Spears still follows me to this day. I don't know why, but I love you, Britney. It was major, like, Ciroc, NBC, E, Bravo. When they saw that I had that type of following, they're like, yeah, if brands and influencers follow you, then there is some sort of influence. But when they saw the way I would speak on Twitter or when I would do commentary and all the retweets, they would say, yeah, you influence people who follow you. So you're definitely an influencer. It didn't really hit until I got an email from, I don't know whether it was Panasonic or, oh, McDonald's. I grew up eating McDonald's. Like, I still eat McDonald's on, like, my cheat days. And McDonald's wants me to host something? I was like, okay, I'm somebody's influencer at the end of the day. So I think for me, I didn't want to get caught up in blogging and thinking that because people love the blog that they loved me. But that's the one true key. They don't really hire you as an influencer just because you have a blog. They hire you because they know that people listen to you and they respect your views and your opinions. So, yes, I'm an influencer.